शुभम कुरुत्वम कल्याणम आरोग्यम धन संपद शत्रु बुद्धि विनाशाय दीपक ज्योतिर्नमोस्तुते दीपक ज्योतिर्नमोस्तुते। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, कैलाश चंद्र पंडा वेलकम्स यू टू ए न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ हिज English environment. I have come today with a beautiful poem that is All Things Bright and Beautiful, which is the first poem of your English lesson. In this episode, we will discuss lyric, substance, and question answer of the first two stanza of the poem. Before going to the poem, let's discuss about the poetess briefly. The poetess of the poem, All Things Bright and Beautiful, is Cecil Frances Alexander. She is an Irish poet who was born in Dublin, a beautiful city in Ireland, in 1818. She is respected as a hymn writer and poet. Her well-known and well-discussed poems collections are Hymn for Children, Christmas Carol, Once in Royal David's City, and Verses for Holy Season. The present poem, All Things Bright and Beautiful, has been derived from her collection of poems, Hymn for Children. Let's listen the first two stanza of the poem.
All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them. Little flower that opens, each little bird that sings, He made their glowing colors, He made their tiny wings. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them all.
You know, students, beauty doesn't reside in the things, but in the mind's eye of the observer. The poet is a lover of beauty. Apart from this, her mind is as holy as that of God. So for her, everything are beautiful. In the first stanza, he says, Everything shines in its own way. Their brightness attracts us. They're also beautiful. Everything are the sources of wisdom. A thoughtful person really gets astonished looking the wonderful creation of God, like the sun, moon, sky, etc. God has created many small creatures like insects, birds, and small animals, as well as some large creatures like lion, elephant, giraffe, brown bear, ostrich, etc. Everything is great, everything is noble, as they have got the holy touch of Almighty God. And Lord God has created them. In the second stanza, the poet gives the example of two beautiful little creations. First, the flower. Flowers are not large creation of God. They are very small, for the Almighty has filled every petals of the flowers with glowing colors. When the flowers bloom, they become attractive because of their shining colors. Again, the birds are no doubt small, but they are famous for their sweet tune. God has provided little birds with tiny wings, which are not only beautiful, but also enable them to fly in the open sky. Now, students, let's discuss some questions and their answer, which are very important for your examination point of view. The first question: who is the poem All Things Bright and Beautiful written by? It is the easy answer. The answer is Cecil Frances Alexander. Now come to the second question. C.F. Alexander is famous for Dash. The answer is for his hymns and writings. Now let's move to the third question. The poem All Things Bright and Beautiful is included in Dash. The answer is the poem collection Hymn for Children. Now come to the next question. How are the things described in the poem All Things Bright and Beautiful? The answer is bright, beautiful, wise and wonderful. Next question. How are the creatures described in the poem All Things Bright and Beautiful? The answer is great and small. The next question. Who, according to C.F. Alexander, created all the things and creatures? The answer is Lord God. The seventh question. What are the little things mentioned in the poem All Things Bright and Beautiful? The answer is little flower and little bird. Now come to the next question. What, according to C.F. Alexander, does open? The answer is the little flowers. How is the flowers described in the poem All Things Bright and Beautiful? The answer is little. The next question. What has God blessed the flowers with? The answer is glowing colors. Now come to the next question. Why is the little flowers attractive? For their glowing color. The next question. Who sings in the poem All Things Bright and Beautiful? The answer is each little bird. Next question. What is the little bird blessed with? The answer is tiny wings. Now come to the next question. What makes the little bird attractive? The same answer. Its tiny wings. The next question. What do you mean by the expression glowing colors? Here glowing color means bright colors. Now, the last question. What do you mean by the word tiny? A tiny means very small. So, students, in this way, we have completed the first two stanza of the poem, All Things Bright and Beautiful. In the next episode, we shall discuss the last four stanzas. Till then, goodbye and stay blessed.